Okay, I'm back. All right, let me open the stream. Let's see if it's already there. There we go, so we can play it right from the app. Let me move it to the right place.
It's just me this time. I'm not on stream anymore.
You're not streaming?
No, I wanted to stop. I wanted to watch this in my living room. I'm on the bigger TV.
Ah, sure. No problem. But great that you're here anyways. So let me ask you, what was the thing that you liked most so far?
It's not developer related, but I'm really excited for Safety Check. I really think that's going to be really useful in a lot of different situations. Oh, so platform. I'm super excited just to see that type of feature in there.
Platform Safety Union is starting right now.
Yeah.
All right.
Open this again.
Is it out of beta now?
It started, yeah.
Let me turn off my music. Oh,
fuck,
out of beta. Pricing.
Looks like I'll be getting out of Xcode Cloud soon.
Yeah.
Oh, they're gonna charge in 2023.
I was not expecting them to charge for this, to be honest.
They're gonna charge for like 25 hours. I think you get 25 hours a month, that's what they just said.
Okay.
Which isn't terrible, but I don't think I'd hit that, but in case I did, I'll just build a bit rise for now.
I missed the full pricing, it was a bit too fast. Nice transition. Lots of async marketing.
Yep. Now we're getting regex.
Yeah, it looks.
I mean, I already know these things because I'm writing the Swift Evolution newsletter and it's all public.
That's really cool.
Yeah. It's cool, but nothing new to me at least. I just found a Swift Charts framework. Check it out. I tweeted it. Ooh. That's really cool. That's also really cool.
Oh, yes.
This is really neat.
Finally!
Mm-hmm. Oh, yay!
Nice.
Don't tell me that I've invested time on a graph for my last app for nothing.
Oh, I was just thinking that when I saw this.
Putain.
So no database but charts.
Okay, God, it's amazing.
This is the big feature this year.
It's gonna be backwards compatible, right? Like,
I don't think so. You mean the charts library?
I mean, I guess it depends on what it's built upon. But, like, I mean, obviously people were able to do this before with SwiftUI. Like, in theory, it should be able to be made at least to iOS 15.
Looking up, the stuff is picking up colors by itself to s- wow. It's amazing.
It's pretty dope.
Seeing how I'm struggling right now with that.
That's pretty dope.
Oh my gosh. See
that change. That's so nice. Oh, all these variations.
Finally.
But this developer, it's just going to be.
That fits, it's amazing. Menu bar extra, fucking god. Oh my gosh.
That's cool.
This is really cool.
Didn't expect charts.
So the system preferences coming up is built on SwiftUI.
They call it widgets.
Yes. Ah, fucking God, finally. So the widget name is accessory circular. I don't remember the names of the concurrent complications. It looks the same.
That's cool. Wow.
It's amazing. It's really cool. It's also time saving like crazy.
That's cool, not having intent definition files.
Yeah, because right now it's not just a line of, I don't know, I'm really bad, but it's not just a line of code now.
It's just ugly having these intent definition files.
Yeah, because right now it's UIKit. Oh, that's far easier than what I don't know. Whoa. That's really cool. I'm asking myself how this can work if you just have PCs. You cannot just offer this way of signing for people without having an iPhone or something like this.
Question: how you can reset your passkey if you like use your phone or something like that? That's like the details that I want to learn in the session.
Right.
Yeah, it looks like Fido 2. If it's Fido 2, you need multiple hardware tokens. So not just your phone, you need something else so you can have safety.
So what this is?
More hardware support. It's becoming a MacBook replacement, more and more.
I will believe this when I will see it.
Wow.
Fucking God.
That's for shops. Retail.
This is it's crazy.
For retail and for IKEA.
Yeah, or hotels. Or... I'm so ignorant in this area, I have no clue what she's talking about.
Yeah, it's for game developers, for sure.
It's like a completely different area for me.
It also works differently. The whole life cycle is different when you're developing a game.
Right.
That's why in my review streams, I don't provide reviews for games because I have no knowledge about games. Different UX.
Definitely. No, that's the same for designer. We are not game designers.
Their own thing. Yeah.
It's another job, basically.
Exactly.
There is a full schedule on the developer app, Jute. I don't know if you saw it.
Oh, it's there.
Yeah, I'm watching on my phone right now to not hear the feed, but desktop class editing iteration. So this variable color in SF symbols.
I'll check it out right after the state.
AppKit. So it's annoying because they are releasing everything at 5 p.m.
Are you going to stay after the union a bit?
Sorry?
Are you going to stay after the platform state of the union?
No, I think I'm going to go to bed if I can find a way to sleep because I need to wake up super early tomorrow morning.
Oh, gosh.
But I'll be back live around 9 a.m. I think tomorrow.
Nice.
I took the full week off.
Nice.
So it means that the whole stuff is working in 3D. It's ready, like you said, it's really ready for us to go something to go in AR with it. AR or VR, actually.
True. What's a view controller? I forgot UI kit.
Meet web push for Safari.
That's cool.
Oh, the amount of sessions is crazy.
That's a cool API. If it's free, but I think it's free.
I'm not sure it's going to be for free, to be honest.
I think it is for free. Otherwise, they would have stated it's beta or something. Like with Xcode Cloud. It's free.
Okay.
Because they are just mentioning a very specific case. Nobody's going to pay for that case.
Yeah, they do Metkit for free, so I'd be very surprised if they did WeatherKit for free also. I mean, if the WeatherKit was paid.
I mean, Xcode Cloud is also different because there's so much servers running. They really cost a lot. Where the weather data, they already have that.
They have to have the weather data no matter what for their...
They're going to kill a lot of business also by providing weather API for free.
They will kill, and they will also provide new features and other apps.
Probably, yeah.
Like, I think I will have multiple ideas where I could use it.
There you go.
I'm annoyed by this in Shubi because to send localization and the API. Third-party APIs I'm using are keeping track of every location sent.
Sorry, I didn't get that.
It is paid.
Oh, no.
Oh.
Seriously. Oh, God.
I mean, I feel like it shouldn't be paid. They already have to have the data. Like, to supply weather on all their phones. I guess the influx of processing the data? I don't know.
Japanese, yes.
Oh, fuck, they didn't add just the Dutch one. Fucking God. Still have to use Google Translate.
All right. So that was the State of the Union.